Okay, I have a question, not a question per se, a kind of inquisitiveness for Abhishek. Okay, Abhishek, a lot of approach which takes along is a giveaway, and which I always value is, you know, sharing information and reaching out to them. And because that is what experience matters, you know, experience gives you an opportunity to help people and understand that. So just pretty inquisitive, because most problem that startups really lack is understanding the legalities, understanding the financials. What is that you really suggest? You know, I would just had from a friend's advice that if I have a startup with me, or if there are multiple of opportunities I have in hand, so what is the suggestions that you start or you would like to give for every startup starting their entrepreneurial journey?
So this is a very relevant, important question, which should be the part of, you know, curriculum of startup education, that while starting up, it's very important. So at the time of incorporation itself, so the common question comes whether we should go for a private limited company or we should incorporate for an LLP. So there are a lot of factors which comes into it, and we can see that 99% of companies are incorporated as private limited companies. There are some school of thoughts which say that due to less compliances, first of all, we should go for an LLP and later on we should convert it into a private limited. So all these aspects basically depends on what is the vision and future prospects of any startup is. If they are not willing to raise external funding, yes, LLP is a very good option. But if they are kind of startup way wherein they want to get more investors on board and world is the market for them, then private limited companies are must go for them. Then at the time of incorporation, like we already mentioned, that there should be some ECPS allotment, which should be part of cap table. Our authorized capital should be more than our paid up capital. And then there are some clauses which should be part of article of association, which makes company investor friendly. As in, when the investors are ready, so we are ready to take funds immediately. We do not have to wait for these compliances to happen. Other than that, in case of startups, it's always like Arnab also mentioned that there are different set of investors who are on board, and every investor has a separate kind of requirement. So as a CFO team, we are always busy in preparing different kinds of reports for the same startup, because every investor want to have a look from its own ways. So it's very important that from the very beginning, you can make a Google Drive kind of thing where you keep on saving all your documents in a systematic way. And whenever there are due diligence which is going in, so you always have all the documents ready at one place. So this is very, you know, general and common thing, which can we can say that's a common sense, but generally people do not practice it. So we need to tell them that we can have all these kind of things. Similarly, we can have a separate functional mail ID, finance@yourcompany.com, which can be used from very beginning, wherein we are getting all the invoices, etc. at that mail ID. So that helps us in storing all the data at one place for our company. So, and of course, for startups, if we talk about, there are many for credit cards. It's a carbon card we get, that's a credit card, for example. So you have a credit card in the name of the company, that is very good, because for example, a startup takes 2 crore rupees funding, they spend 1.5 crore rupees credit card, and their personal tax returns are 5 lakh, 6 lakh rupees. So they end up paying, getting notices from income tax department. So if we have a corporate credit card, that is useful. For managing payroll, there are a lot of tools, a lot of startups. We use particularly Opin that has been acquired by Razorpay. So even if you have 2 employees or 3 employees, so you can use those kind of tools there. Automated payroll, it's that automated payslips are generated, expires the TDS returns, and these employees also get a feel like they're working with some big companies. Similarly, there are many other tools, like for invoicing, we use Zoho Books, QuickBooks, and then Tally also have a lot of advanced features nowadays. There are apps like BizAnalyst, which gives us anytime access to our books of accounts. So these are few tips which we have, like, we can talk about, we can have a separate session on all these aspects basically. But yeah, these are few tips from finance perspective which is there for startups.
Lovely. Thanks for the information, Abhishek.